Welcome to this video. In this video, we shall discuss Hall effect in semiconductor. This effect was discovered by American physicist Edwin Hall in 1879. So in 1879, this American physicist Hall, he applied electric and magnetic fields simultaneously to a conductor, and these electric and magnetic fields were perpendicular to each other. And he found that when these two fields, electric and magnetic fields, are applied perpendicular to each other, then electric field or the voltage is developed in the conductor, which is again perpendicular to both electric and magnetic fields. So this phenomenon is known as Hall effect. So before going to Hall effect, first we will study what is Fleming's left hand rule. Now when magnetic field is applied perpendicular to current carrying conductor, then it exerts force on that conductor, and the direction of force is given by Fleming's left hand rule. Okay. Now what is Fleming's left hand rule? So I will show you by this diagram. So these are the three fingers of the left hand. So this is the thumb, this is forefinger, and this is middle finger. So this is the current, this is magnetic field, and this is the direction of force. Okay. So what is the Hall effect? So I will discuss now to you. So this is my left hand, and see, you hold these three fingers. This is thumb, this is forefinger, and this is middle finger. So hold these fingers in such a fashion that they are perpendicular to each other. Okay. Now this middle finger, it denotes direction of current. Please remember, this is direction of current. See, current means positive charge. This is direction of applied magnetic field. See, this is perpendicular to current. Okay. Then force on the conductor or force on the charged particles is denoted, or it is represented by thumb. So this is Fleming's left hand rule. So how to remember it? Just to remember FBI. Okay. F, force, means the thumb. B means the magnetic field, it is forefinger. And I means current, it is middle finger. So FBI. So you remember in this fashion, FBI. Okay. So now we come to our point, that is Hall effect. Okay. So here you consider this is the conductor. Okay. So apply the electric field in X direction. You can see here current in X direction. Okay. So electric field in X direction. So current in X direction. So this is the magnetic field in Z direction. Okay. So now we apply the Fleming's left hand rule, and you tell me what is the direction of force on the charged particle. Okay. So this is current in X direction. You know, current means positive charge, magnetic field in Z direction. So you apply the Fleming's left hand rule and you tell me what is the direction of force on the charged particle. Okay. So we will see like this. See, this is the current. It is positive particle, motion of positive charge. And see, this is the field and this is the force. But if you observe our figure, see, in our figure we have seen the magnetic field is pointing out. See, this I am showing pointing in. So magnetic field is pointing out. So the force would be in downward direction. Got it? Force would be in downward direction. Okay. Now suppose we have electrons. Now this is the direction of positive charge. This is the current. So obviously the electrons would be in this direction. Would be in opposite direction. So the force on current would be in downward direction. Okay. Force will be in downward direction. Got it? So electrons are deflected in downward direction, so they get collected at the bottom surface. So the bottom surface gets negative charge and obviously the positive charge is induced on top surface. Okay, so this is negative charge, this is positive charge. So what does it mean? It means the electric field is developed in y direction. Got the point? See, current in x direction means applied field, electric field in x direction, magnetic field in z direction, and the induced electric field is in y direction. So this we call Hall field. Okay, and the voltage is called as Hall voltage. So this is the Hall effect. Okay, so we will derive equation for Hall voltage and Hall field. Now, when magnetic field is applied to current carrying conductor, what is the force? It is given by Lorentz and it is known as Lorentz force. So this is the equation for that. F is equal to minus E, E plus V cross B is the applied field. V is the velocity, drift velocity of the charged particle, and B is the magnetic field. Now this force is in downward direction by Fleming's left hand rule, just we have seen. Now due to induced field, see, positive charge is in the upper surface. So suppose the current is due to negative charge. So the force due to Hall field is in upward direction because here it is positive. So what does it mean? The Hall field is opposite to Lorentz force. The force due to Hall field is opposite to Lorentz force. So these two forces, they oppose each other or they counteract. So in equilibrium, the two forces will become equal and opposite, and the net force becomes zero. Okay, in equilibrium, Lorentz force and the force due to Hall field will become zero. Okay, and what we get? Zero is equal to minus E, Ey minus Vx, Vz. Vy, because Hall field is in y direction, we know drift velocity in x direction and magnetic field in z direction. So Ey is equal to Vx, Vz. Now what is the Hall field? Hall voltage is equal to Eyd. You can see in the figure, see, d is the width of the sample, and we know the voltage per unit length is the Hall field. So Vh is equal to Ey into D. Vh is equal to Ey into D. Okay. Now, so we get these two equations. Now we know current density. What is current density? Current per unit area. Okay. Current per unit area. It is minus NeVx. Minus means we assume that current is due to electrons because we consider the pure conductor. So we take negative, and Vx is the drift velocity, and N is the electron concentration. It is the concentration we are considering, and so it is current density. So from this formula, Vx is equal to minus Jx upon Ne. So put this in this equation, we get Ey is equal to minus Jx upon Ne into Bz. Okay, so what we do, we take this Jx Bz to LHS. So what we get? Ey upon Jx Bz. Now see, what is Ey? It is the Hall field developed or induced. Jx is the current density, B is the applied field. So what does it mean? It is the field induced or developed for unit current density and unit magnetic field. Can we define like this? So voltage or field developed for unit current density, unit applied magnetic field is defined as Rh, that is Hall coefficient. So this is the definition of Hall coefficient. And see, from this equation we get Rh is equal to minus 1 upon Ne. N is the electron concentration, and minus sign, it is just for the electron. Electron is negatively charged. Now put equation 2 in equation 1. Vh is equal to Eyd. Ey is Vx, Vz. And then put Vx, Jx upon Ne in that equation and see what you get. You write the equation. Okay, correct. We get Vh, Hall voltage, is equal to Jx upon Ne, Bzd. So many times we do not put this suffix, just they indicate the direction, x direction, z direction. So not necessary every time we write that suffix. So from this equation, what we see? Suppose we pass a constant current and we apply the constant field. Now we know for given sample, D is constant, width of the sample. So can we say VH is inversely proportional to N? N is the carrier concentration or charge concentration. Hall voltage is inversely proportional to charge concentration. Okay. Again, we come to definition RH is equal to 1 upon NE. Now we know sigma. Sigma is the conductivity. It is NE mu E. What is mu E? It is the mobility of electrons. E suffix, it is for electron. Now what is the mobility? It is drift velocity when unit electric field is applied, or when 1 volt per meter electric field is applied, the velocity acquired by the electron is mobility, it is mu E. See, from these equations we can write mu E is equal to RH sigma. Now we know generally we do not measure current density, but we measure total current. And so total current I is equal to J into A. A is the area of the surface through which current is flowing. Now in our figure, it is D into T. Okay, it is D into T. This is the area. So A is DT. A is DT. So I is equal to J D DT. So we put it in the equation. And what we get, VH is equal to I upon NEA BZD. Okay. Now A means DT. So this D will get cancelled and we get I upon NET BZ, or we get VH is equal to I upon NETB or IB upon NET. Okay. So from this equation, we can find out the voltage, Hall voltage. So what is the significance of Hall effect? See, from these equations we can find out N, that is carrier concentration. We can find out mobility. Once we know RH, we find it, we determine it by doing this experiment, performing the experiment. Sigma is known, we can find out the mobility. And very important that we can know the what is the type of semiconductor. Okay, what is the type of semiconductor? For example, if it is N-type semiconductor, on the bottom surface, electrons are collected. And if it is P-type semiconductor, on the bottom surface, holes are collected. So, from the sign of Hall voltage, we can know the type of semiconductor, whether it is P-type or N-type. Now, one question to you. Why the value of Hall voltage is greater for semiconductor than for metal? Because Hall effect is studied for semiconductor, generally studied for semiconductor. We do not get it for metal or for conductor. Why? So you think over this question and you write this answer in our discussion forum in the Moodle. Okay, once again I repeat my question. Why Hall voltage is greater for semiconductor than metal? Okay, so in the next video, we will solve the numericals.